so excited to be joined by Steve Shah from our product team to have a conversation about generative AI, automation, and automation anywhere.
Excellent. Thank you, Micah. Glad to be here.
Awesome. Let's jump right in. What upcoming features are you most excited about launching, and how will they improve our customer experience?
That's easy. I am super pumped. All the generative AI stuff is amazing. We just launched three big technologies. We've got upcoming dates for them. So everything that we're doing around our AI work is absolutely phenomenal. So excited to see that, especially some of the tools for being able to help out the co-pilot use case. I think the co-pilot use case is going to be exciting. Which brings me to the second one I'm super excited about, and that's co-pilot. Co-pilot, if you think about it, it's actually three technologies in one, right? There's the co-pilot piece, which makes the whole experience, it's able to bring automation, the experience into any application. But then there's also the process orchestration capabilities as well as the API capabilities. So all three of them work in concert with one another, absolutely incredible stuff. I think that's a real game changer in terms of what the experience will be for a lot of automation. And then I think the last one that I'm super jazzed about is actually, I'm gonna double click on that API one, because that API one is phenomenal. We're talking about being able to run automations in milliseconds, as opposed to needing a couple of seconds for the Windows login to happen and all that other stuff to happen. This makes the whole opportunity for leveraging these really easy to build automations to be able to get integrated into really interactive use cases. So that just opens up a whole new world for us in terms of where automation can go.
That's awesome. I'm super excited about those, and I'm personally really excited to get hands-on with more of that, because I think our developer audience is going to be really excited to see where they can take some of that.
Absolutely. I'm super jazzed myself.
What new automation opportunities or use cases do you think will be unlocked by some of these new capabilities that are being released?
Oh my goodness. That's not a fair question, man. Because there's so much you can do with this, right? And I mean, that's always been the power of A360, is it's this Swiss Army knife where you could go in any direction. So what I'm excited about is that with all of these use cases, especially around AI, what you need in all of those situations is making sure that there's still, call it adult supervision, right? You want to make sure that there is somebody who's going to go and look over the work, bring a human into the element before the work goes and changes what could possibly be someone's life.
Yeah.
Right. So that's very important to me, and I think it's important to the company as a whole. So the guardrails we put into place that make that easy to do for being able to break out and bring that human into the loop is super important. And so as I think about use cases, I really look at how do we make sure that guardrails are part of that use case, because those are the ones that will be able to go and make meaningful changes in the short term.
Yeah, absolutely. And that's the difference between firing off a random generative AI created email versus have someone actually take a look at it, provide some insight, provide some feedback, check it over once.
You don't want to get surprised by the email that gets written.
Yeah. Absolutely. What, you know, I've been really impressed with how quickly Automation Anywhere has been able to respond to integrating generative AI capabilities into what we're doing on a daily basis. So what about the Automation Anywhere architecture makes that feasible and makes it possible for us to be so responsive in releasing a lot of these capabilities?
So this goes back to our last conversation, actually, because in the last time we talked, I was just going on and on about microservices and the pluggable architecture and all of the crazy things that you could do with that. And what was amazing about that was that we would be able to go and add new capabilities into the system without being disruptive about what else is already there. So if you've got production work happening on A360, I don't want to break it. It's just, you know, too much critical work happens on A360. I take that very seriously. When we bring on something new, especially something as wild as generative AI, we're now able to do that in its own little universe where a disruption there, because it's brand new and we're still figuring it out, does not affect something that is in production. So pluggable architecture, microservices, all of those things become critical elements of our architecture.
Yeah, absolutely. And so the pluggable architecture, just so I understand what you're saying, you're talking about the ability for us to have versioning on our packages, for automations that are created to reference a very specific version, so that if it was created, let's say 6 months ago, it's going to deploy tomorrow with the exact same packages and exact same versions.
Exactly. Once you get something to work, I don't want to break it.
Right. Great. As a product leader, how do you focus on what new features and new technologies that you want to integrate into the product? And how do you prioritize those things? Because there's a lot of competing priorities I know you must face.
Well, I started by asking, you know, my CEO for like 1,000 more engineers, and he laughed at me much that way. And said no. Mm-hmm. So the prioritization basically goes, number one, things around trust. Our customer trust is paramount. Security falls into that bucket. If there's something that's changing what that environment looks like, that goes straight to the top because those are too critical to have any risks around. The second thing that we really look at is what would I refer to as voice of the customer. That is, you know, what's everyone asking for? Because those connect very tightly to real concrete use cases that, you know, people want to do now. And so we want to make sure that we bring that to bear. And I think in the last year, we did about close to 150 of them. I mean, it was remarkable how many changes we made. And then from there, we're able to go and look at kind of broader what's changing up in the market. So like something like generative AI, which wouldn't have come from voice of the customer. It's so new. That is something that we go and do sort of at the tail end of this, and we make sure there's enough space to be able to do new and interesting things there.
Steve, thank you so much for joining me. This has been an awesome conversation, as always. We're going to do more of these because I think it's always fun to sit down and geek out with you on technology.
Yeah, same here. Thanks, Micah.
Yeah.